My friend Adam, he was playing this game Trace Vector, and it looked really neat. It was done in this retro style, the same as Asteroids and some other arcade games. And the difference is, it actually did use a conventional LCD screen, unlike the vector displays. So computers and all of them use, for the last many years, use screens that are raster-based. So they start at the top and they go to the bottom. Little, you know, effectively draws from the top and goes down. And the same thing with CRTs. The difference was, on some of these retro games, they would actually control the position of the beam so they could write out text. And I thought to myself, how would I do that? Well, conveniently, oscilloscopes have this little XY feature in which you can control the position of the beam. Let's turn that off real quick. And you can control it. You can move it in the X position and in the Y position. And when you do this, you can do this rather by controlling the voltage on the X input and the Y input. But that would mean I have to get a voltage from the computer to the oscilloscope at high speed. Where am I going to find a high-speed digital to analog converter? Conveniently, every computer's got this cool thing called a VGA port. So for all of $3, just putting together some resistors and a VGA port, I can now take the red and blue channels and hook them up to X and Y respectively. So let's take a look at this computer right here and see what that would look like if I were to output that. Right now, we're seeing a picture. It's completely meaningless because what's actually happening is the computer would be scanning from the top and then going down, and the red color, the amount of red, how intense it is the X position, and the amount of blue, or the intensity of the blue, is the Y position. So this is a picture, even if you can't really see it as one. Let's output it on the oscilloscope. Just gonna have to turn this back up. There. Let's try to get this recentered again. Okay. Now we have this image on the oscilloscope, and this is done by having the X and Y hooked up to here and here, and being able to move the beam and draw all of the text and this cute little heart shape. In addition, I have this LSM-303 here. It's a magnetometer that I have a magnet in my hand right now, so I have basically a non-contact mechanism of input. And I can control various parameters of this game, so to speak, with the magnet and the magnetometer. So here I'm controlling a little heart. This is a little bit boring by my standards. So I also wrote this game, and it's not really a game, I guess, but tech demo, that has a mesh that I can control using the same magnetometer. Just calibrate it and then I can go. And I can drive around on this wonderful screen. And you're seeing that all of these areas, it's actually not being rasterized. It's being drawn by drawing each one of the little line segments one at a time. And this is in the same sort of style of drawing that games like Asteroids and some other arcade games used. So I now have this vector display hooked up to this computer, and a reasonable means to be able to control the output. So I'm curious if anybody else has any other interesting things they'd want to do with something like this, or just to see where other people go with this sort of thing. Hope you liked it, hope you thought it was cool. Don't forget to subscribe to my videos. Thanks for watching!
Oh no, it's shrinking. Oh, the computer is going to standby. Oh, oh well.